What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be creating a landscape integrated stair. So a stair that's made out of stones, and it's part of the landscape. Now this is a little bit difficult inside of Revit, because Revit really doesn't like things that look kind of organic. It really likes straight lines and flat surfaces. So this is going to be a bit of a challenge, but there is a workflow that we can follow, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing today. Now, if you want to learn more about Revit or learn more creative solutions, I would like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to be linking it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 130 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. I'm basically creating a really big database of knowledge for Revit. Now also there you can find some of my ready-to-go customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, as well as a plugin, so make sure to check that out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are at Revit's homepage. So what I'm going to be doing first is simply going here to new, and then I'm going to start a new project. For the template file, I'm going to be using my architecture design template, the metric version. Now, if you want to get access to my templates, you can find them on my website. As I said, I'm going to be leaving a link to those up in the cards as well. Okay, now let's click OK, and let's let Revit start right up. So as soon as Revit starts up, what I'm going to be doing first is going to my site plan, and then let's get rid of the start page, or actually let's go into the 3D view first. And then here I'm just going to edit my level 2 down from 360 to 200 centimeters. The reason why I'm doing this is just because I want a shorter stair, just so the tutorial is a little bit more simple. Now also what we're going to need for this tutorial is going to be a rock family. Now I found one online, so this is the rock. Let me just drag over that family, so it's going to update, and it's going to insert that rock family there. So this is what that looks like. So yeah, it's just a simple rock family. I think it was imported from SketchUp or something. So anyways, that's the rock that we're going to be using. Now for this particular rock, we do have to have some measurements in order to see what our stair is going to be like. So I'm just going to go here to the site plan, zoom in on the rock, and let's do a quick little measurement of the length of it. So it's going to be about, yeah, I'm going to put it at around 45 centimeters. So let's say that kind of the top flat part is 45. Then we want to have the height. So again, you don't have to be really too specific, but let's just check out kind of the main thickness here. If we look from a different one, so from the east, you can see, yeah, so the main thickness is kind of this part here. So anyways, let's measure that quickly. So it's around 17, 18, which is perfect for a stair. So that's 18 by 45, let's say. So it's not a perfect stair, but obviously when you're making a stair out of rocks in the landscape, you're not looking for a perfect stair. You're just looking for a way to get up the hill. So let's now move to the next point, and that is to create a stair. So I'm just going to be creating a regular stair, and we're going to be using that as reference in order to place our rocks and align our landscaping. So what I'm going to do now is just go here to our stair tool. For the stair type, I'm just going to be using the monolithic stair. And then here we have to go into edit type and make some adjustments. So the maximum riser height, I'm fine with that. The minimum tread depth, let's go to 45, for example. Okay, hit apply. Okay, and now we can go here, and as you can see, it's going from level 1 up to level 2. That's perfectly fine. And then the actual riser height is 16, and the tread depth is 28. So let's move this one to 45, hit apply, and then for this, instead of 12, let's try 11. Okay, so that's going to give us 18.18, which I find fine. So I'm just going to OK out of that, even though it kind of overshot, but by like 2 centimeters, or no, by 2 millimeters. Yeah, so I don't think that's going to be too much of a problem. So anyways, let's take this, and then let's place the run. So you're just going to come here, click, drag this out, click again, and we have our stair. So there we go. Now what you can do here is, just to make it simple for yourself, go to railing and just make sure that it has none. Click OK. So when you finish, it's not going to have any railings that you would have to delete. Okay, so once we have the stair in place, now let's model the landscape. So what I'm going to do now is go to our site plan. So I know it's about 2 meters on top, and then I know it's 0 on the bottom. So let's go to our massing and site. Let's now go to topo surface, and then let's start placing some points. So I'm just going to place a few points down here, then I'm going to place a few points up here, and then let's move this to 2 meters. Oh, that's 200 centimeters. Okay, and then let's place a few points like so. Maybe move in this side a little bit just to make it a bit more symmetrical. Okay, and move this one out. Okay, and then finally let's select these two and copy them out, so it's like 2 meters there, and then we can move this one and this one to the outside a little bit, just so it looks better. Okay, and then this is what we have. This is our topography, and then you can hit finish. Now you can play around with the stair. So if you're not, if you want to make some changes, for example, we can do it like this, where I'm just going to embed the bottom of the stair like this, and then I'm going to be showing you how you kind of fix this up later on, just to make it a little bit more difficult for ourselves. Okay, so once we have this in check, now it's time to start modifying topography to follow around the stair. So you do this by going to edit surface, and then what you want to do is go to your site plan, and the next step is going to be placing some points around the stairs. Now these points, you want them to be you just want additional points to be on the surface without editing the surface. So you can do this by going to place point, and then switching here from absolute elevation to relative to surface. So once you do this, when you place a point, it's just going to be there. If you add an elevation here, it's going to bring it up or down by the value that you enter here. So if you place 10 centimeters, when you place a point, it's just going to be 10 centimeters above the original position on the topo surface. So anyways, now just to see a little bit better where this stair is, I'm going to switch this to wireframe. Okay, and then you just go a little bit towards the outside of the stair. It's kind of like this. And okay, so it might do this, that's perfectly fine. And then you just want to place just a bunch of points there off to the side of the stair, just like that. Then you want to do the same thing on the other side, so just like this. So just a bunch of these points off to the side. Okay, so once we have those points off to the side, and let's move these a little bit more like that. Okay, actually let me just go back. It's usually not a good idea to move these points, so you can just add new ones if you're not happy with the current position, and then delete the old ones. Just like that. Okay, so once we have the points on the outside, now you want to start placing some points on the actual stair. So what you want to do here is just start placing points like this. So 3 points. So just like this on both sides, just like that. So one in the middle of the step, one in the front, the middle, the front, and so on. So you're just going to repeat this for the rest of the stair. I'm just going to fast forward. And as you can see, I've just added all of the extra points here, and also I've added some additional points on the outside too. Now it's time to adapt all of these points to their proper position. So I'm just going to switch to the 3D view, and then here a good idea would be to go into wireframe, just like that. And now it's time to start adapting the position of these points. So what you want to do now is go to the align tool. AL is the shortcut. You want to check multiple align, and then here you have wall faces, faces of core, and so on. This doesn't really matter for this particular case. So anyways, now let's start. You want to select the top of the first step or the tread, click, and then you want to align this point, this point, this point, and this point. Then you want to click outside, click on the next one, and just start over. So this point, this point, this point, this point. So you're going to have 4 points on each of the threads. So again, click outside, click on the face of the thread, and then the 4 points that are above that. And you're just going to repeat this process until you get to the bottom of your stair. I know it's a little bit time consuming, but it does give you the desired result, and that's what we want to see. So you're just going to continue doing that. Again, I'm just going to fast forward this so you don't have to watch each individual one. And here we go. So what you'll see here is for just the bottom ones, or the last two, I have attached them to the bottom of the stairs, so this face over here. Okay, so once we have that in place, you can see this looks a little bit weird. It's going to look super weird when we turn off the hidden line. So it's going to look like this, like it's kind of digged in a little bit. Especially if I go to shaded. Yeah, so see how it has that. Perhaps a good way to look at this would be just to go to finish and then go to the site plan and just run a quick section through the stair. Just like that. And then what you'll see is here, as you can see, that the topography kind of goes up a little bit at the bottom. So we can easily fix this by going back to the 3D view or the site plan or wherever, go to edit surface, and then you just want to select these two bottom points, go to copy, and then you just want to copy them out. Copying them out once did the job. And there we go. So now if I hit finish, there we go. So now, as you can see here, the stair is kind of dug in, especially at the bottom. So if I run a section horizontally, not like that, let's see. Okay, let's get rid of this. Okay, so if I run a section like so, what you'll see there is, as you can see, the topography is kind of dug in a little bit at the stair, which is usually what you would see for kind of this type of a project. So that's perfectly fine. And there we go. So now we have the stair that's kind of embedded in the topography, and now it's time to add the rocks, because we don't want to leave it like this. So for the rock, you want to find it first, and then you want to place it there. Okay, so that's kind of at the first step. Let's go to the site plan. So kind of like that, I guess. Let's see what this looks like. Okay, so you can actually use arrow keys, and if you zoom out, it's going to be a bit easier to navigate. So that seems correct. Now also what you want to do is go to your section, the first one that we have created, just to set up the elevation. So this actually has to be kind of the actual first step. So you're just going to come in here like so, and then just going to dig it in the terrain a little bit like that. See? Okay, so this is now the first step. Then you want to copy it. So you just go to copy, multiple, and then you want to use this tip of the stair as kind of your endpoint for kind of grabbing it. And then you can just copy it as many times as you want all the way up to the top. So you copy it as many times as you have it. In this case, as you have seen, we don't really have too much of it. And then for the last one, let's just place it like that. Pull it out a little bit. There we go. Okay, now let's go to the 3D view. This is what that looks right now. And then we can just select the stair, and then you can hide that element or you can delete it. And this is what that stair will look like. So you're going to have the rock at the top and then a little bit of grass or earth in the back. Usually these types of stairs would actually look like this. So this actually looks exactly how you want it to look. Now, just to add a little bit more variety, what I would do is I would go to the site plan and then select the first rock, go to rotate, and then go 180. Go to the next one, or the kind of the fourth one, so every other one, and rotate them by 180. So this will give you a bit more variety. So you're just rotating the rocks in order to make them seem a bit more random, because obviously you wouldn't find like a same rock in nature and then just find like 11 of those or 12. Anyways, see how now it all looks a little bit different. And then also I would just play around a little bit with their position. So perhaps off to the side a little bit. So maybe this one can go like that, this one there. So you can just kind of play around with their position, pull it out a little bit. This one, can move it like that. So you kind of play around with the positioning of those rocks, and in the end, you get something that looks way more natural. And then finally, just to see what you have done, what you have accomplished, let's go back to the site plan and let's make a little 3D view camera like that. Let's see here. So let's go down a little bit. Yeah, I think this looks nice. Okay, and then you want to hide the stair here as well. And then you can create a rendering just to see what that looks like. So let's try that. So let's do a quick rendering here, make it a little bit bigger, and let's see what we have. And this is what we have as a result. So as you can see, we have our rocks. It looks exactly what this would look like in nature, I think, for kind of a quick Revit job, just setting up these rocks. I think it looks really, really good. So please tell me if you've enjoyed this, and if you want to get this Revit project file as well as all of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page. I'm going to be including that as a link in the description of this video, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.